Hello, and welcome back to the Exactpro channel. My name is Anna Marie. I'm Marketing Director at Exactpro. At Exactpro, we build software to test software. Check out our website, exactpro.com, if you want to learn more about us. If you're new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to make sure you don't miss the new videos. Today, we are going to talk about overcoming data sources issues when testing virtual assistants in finance. AI-powered chatbots, also called virtual assistants, VA, are increasingly popular in financial services, with almost every bank launching VA services in the past decade. Unlike traditional financial software, VAs interact with users through a dialogue based on natural language while applying third-party services to discern information and perform various actions on their behalf. The VA collects multidimensional data such as client requests and personal information and uses machine learning algorithms to analyze the data. This analysis then enhances the quality and individualization of the VA's responses. There is no doubt about the technology's potential usefulness, especially in customer engagement. However, AI rewards come with risks. In 2019, Tinkoff Bank debuted the Oleg VA, embedded in the bank's application. Though very powerful from technological point of view, the virtual assistant wasn't perfect from the customer satisfaction perspective. When a client contacted Oleg about a problem with the fingerprint logging, the chatbot that was trained on the open source text data using Kolmogorov supercomputer capabilities could not provide a better response than "they should cut your fingers off. That will serve you right." Oleg's response demonstrates a quite peculiar but very human reaction, indicating successful training on the underlying AI model. However, the VA being trained on the open source data instead of data specific to financial services caused a communicative failure. A chatbot-assisted user interface can also face another type of communicative risk. Even within a totally smooth conversation, it may not be enough for a banking VA to simply respond to whatever a user says. Sometimes there are situations where a client would input something like, "My spouse passed away, what do I do with the account?" This is when, ideally, a chatbot should recognize that human interference is needed. To mitigate the risk, it is important to test such conversational systems. However, it is quite challenging because the model behind them is trained on huge data sets. Given that the expected system behavior is not strictly defined, both user inputs and the VA outputs are crucial to the validation and verification process. In the financial industry, these testing challenges inherent to AI systems are compounded by data access issues. Frequently, a VA is trained on data that a third-party testing provider is unable to access due to its sensitivity nature. For example, a testing team may need to evaluate a banking application chatbot designed to communicate with the bank's clients, and based on those chats, make changes in the bank's database associated with the client account. Without access to the existing user chatbot interaction records, it is challenging for testers to create training datasets from scratch. Even at the starting point, when very basic interaction scenarios are covered with the most standard input and output phrases, the testing team needs to predict how exactly clients may formulate their questions and answers. It is even more challenging to suggest all the possible ways that users can unintentionally transform these inputs with misprints, omissions, or other errors caused by lack of attention, lack of effort, or illiteracy. Ultimately, even when a dataset of possible user inputs associated with different scenarios is modeled, the evaluator still needs to identify what system's responses are correct and what responses are failures for a specific user input and as a part of a particular scenario. These challenges can be mitigated through a hybrid, two-pronged approach to testing. First, the tester collects interaction logs pulled from conversations between the VA and the test and manual testers, and then annotates them in line with VA's set of skills. This categorization allows the testers to generate test scenarios designed to evaluate the chatbot's performance on different levels. The second prong would be leveraging the collected data for automated tests using natural language processing (NLP) technologies to determine how robust the VA is. For example, the tester can evaluate the VA's ability to process test input by feeding it spelling and syntax variations. Or the chatbot can be tested on how well it can identify the user's needs, match it with a specific skill area, and then respond appropriately with an answer or action. The recommended approach focuses on VA's quality attributes, such as performance, functionality, and accessibility. A variation on this approach involves combining the collected data with additional data from other sources. An evaluation may involve mixing phrases that signal the user's intents associated with different skills, to test whether the system's response is to switch to another intent or ask a clarifying question. The results of this testing are less interpretable but can be beneficial given a large volume and a variety of stimuli. As the technology underpinning chatbots develops, so will their evaluations. Future research is aimed at addressing other characteristics that contribute to the financial VAs – effectiveness, efficiency, and overall user satisfaction. Automated evaluation of conversational systems remains challenging, and this recommended approach may help overcome the main problem in testing of AI systems – the issues around obtaining and expanding the training dataset, especially in the context of knowledge domains strongly affected by data sensitivity and data privacy issues. The Exactpro team has developed a test harness able to provide quality assurance testing for chatbots. If you're looking to have your chatbot tested, contact us. You'll find our contact details in the description below. This is all for today. Thanks so much for staying with me. If you found our approach useful, feel free to share this video with your friends and colleagues and give us a thumbs up. I'll see you soon.